You know that you're going to get either soft weave or leatherette. But now. Beyond upholstery, sizing is your most important choice when you buy your chair. Whether you're on Reddit, Facebook, comment sections of my other videos, it's anxiety-inducing, it's everywhere, it can change absolutely everything.
What chair do I get?
Well, that's why you're watching this, duh. The Titan 2022 comes in three main sizes, small, regular, and XL. Each one of these has certain size recommendations for both height and weight. Given this, you might be tempted to pick one and just be done with it. But wait!
There's a ton of variation in body shape amongst people of the same height.
And also, the correct size chair is the function of a lot of different things. Your individual body type, your preference for seating, and your setup. So, which chair is right for you? Best case scenario, try the chair for yourself and see if it fits right, whether it's comfortable, ergonomic, whether it suits your needs. If you're lucky enough to live near a showroom, awesome, go try your chair. But if you're not so lucky...
Buy them all.
Just kidding. Watch these quick and easy sizing tips so you can buy the right chair for you. Tip number one, look at the technical specs for the chair you want to buy and measure. If you want the clearest indication that the chair is going to fit you, this is the best way. You don't need to go crazy doing measurements though. The two most important ones are your BPL and, for good measure, your hip width. BPL is important because it does influence what kind of seat is acceptable for you. So you'll want to check that out. BPL is actually super easy to measure. Just take a measuring tape and then measure the distance from your butt down to the back of your knee. My BPL is, for example, about 50 centimeters, which makes me a good fit for the regular and the small, but not for the XL. And don't just take it from me, take it from Secretlab Ergonomics Advisory Board member, Dr. Jordan Tsai. Because if your BPL is less than the seat depth, you risk cutting off your circulation or worse, being unable to use the backrest. Which is why for an ergonomic fit, then you may want to size down if the seat depth is much bigger than your BPL. There's a ton of variation in people's bodies that may make one chair right for you but wrong for another person. Could be that you have short legs and a long torso. Get a chair too large and you won't be able to use the backrest. Although maybe if you have long thighs and short calves, you can size up, though if it's the reverse, that's probably not such a good idea. If your hip width is too wide, or you're above the weight limit for a given chair despite your height, you may have to get a larger chair. Say you get the S because it suits your height but you're wider than the minimum armrest distance. You're gonna have a bad time cause it'll be too narrow, you'll be squashed in, and you will not fit the chair. And so that brings us right to tip number two. For comfort, size up. And this is official Secretlab advice, by the way. So let's look at a quick case study that shows why this might make sense. The Titan 2020, for example, is a chair that suits my seating preference and my setup, but not my body type.
When I sit on the Titan 2020, my feet just barely touch the ground.
Yet it's one of my favorite chairs and it continues to be a workhorse. That's because if a chair is larger than your recommended size,
it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world, damn it.
Okay, let's start again. Even if a chair is larger than your recommended size, if your BPL is still longer than the seat depth, you can adapt to it with a footrest and thereby achieve an ergonomic seating position. If you don't want to be tied to your footrest though, measure your popliteal height and compare that to the minimum floor to seat base distance of your desired chair. No worries, I'll link this in the description so you can cross-reference with your measurements. For now though, sizing up will also make it easier to sit in different positions. Larger chair equals more seating flexibility, which might be something that you can't necessarily get with a smaller chair because of a smaller seat base, which can be less forgiving if you like to sit cross-legged, for example. Now, I'm 170 and I'm sized between both chairs, so I happen to also own them both, so let's try them out and I'll give you my impressions.
A classic favorite, and that's basically sitting knee cross over your leg. With the regular right here, it's very comfortable. I can just go ahead and move here and there. My range of motion is not unduly restricted.
For both these chairs at my height of 170, so my feet can touch the ground, though for the R, it's only on the lowest setting. While it is admittedly a little bit easier to move around with the small, I do prefer the cross-legged sitting capacity of the regular and larger.
If I want, I can go ahead and cross my legs, like that. Your classic Secretlab experience.
But
if you try to do this on the S, there's a bit of a problem right here.
When you cross your legs on a Titan S, right?
You just won't have that much room to kind of like freely move around. It's gonna be very easy for you to just fall off. The same would not be the case with the regular Titan. And you can see right here, I can just amply move around and there's no issues whatsoever.
On the Arctic White Small,
there's just a little bit less room for me in terms of like balance and space, etc.
So for me personally, I do prefer the regular to the small. And that doesn't always apply just because you're on the borderline.
We have here a professional chair tester.
A lady of the hour who is casually filming this thing right here. Where did this come from, man?
Oh, this is a gift from my daughter. And I expect one from my son.
Be careful what you wish for.
The chair that you're sitting on right now is a medium Titan. So how do you feel? Is it comfortable?
Of course, otherwise why would I sit on this chair?
Nan, how tall are you?
I'm as tall as you see. How tall I am. I'm not so short. I can be very tall.
I'm gonna cry.
So mom is about 162, which places her solidly under the height recommendation for the regular Titan.
Your feet are not exactly on the ground.
And they'll put a stool there.
Yeah, you can do that. That's fine. Box yourself over. Let's try to go from here, the chair that you're sitting on right now, to over here.
You better pay me well.
Excuse me. I want you to pay attention to how you feel in the different chairs.
I think this one suits me more.
Well, you feel that this one suits you more? Okay,
yes.
So why is that?
Because my back just num-num.
Now, for those of you who are asking about pillow heights, this was a really common question, but as you can see, at the lowest point for the regular, the pillow is just hitting the base of my mom's head, while for the small, it is hitting more around her neck. So if that's a big factor for you, then something to consider. But you can actually use the pillow out of the magnetic region anyway, so it's not a huge issue. So it's pretty clear that my mom suits the S, but why don't we ask her what she prefers?
This one not so good.
Not so good.
This one for reading, for anything, relaxation.
It's a bit bigger, right?
You think? Yeah.
Okay, so how do you feel in the chair?
Okay, very comfortable.
You're about 5 foot.
I don't feel like getting up.
You don't? So which one do you feel is more comfortable?
Still this one. I'm a bit biased, maybe. Maybe this is the chair that I first fell in love already, so I can't change my love for another one.
Oh dear.
So that's just a matter of personal preference, but at the very least, I hope it illustrates that you don't necessarily need to be a bigger person to be able to appreciate a bigger chair. But I mean, the Titan S is my piano chair though, so yeah, I've got to give credit for that. Perfect piano chair. Oh, quick bonus. If you owned a Titan or Omega from a previous generation, you can size by relative sizing. Not those relatives. So if the Titan 2020 was just a little bit bigger than what you were rated for, the Titan Evo 2022 small and regular are both shorter in terms of hydraulics than the Titan 2020 and also the Omega. Oh, and I threw in the XL here for good measure, so if that's something that you're interested in, hopefully this helps you decide. If nothing else, I hope it'll help you look more critically at sizing recommendations as well. Okay, last tip, this will be a quick one. A lot of people do wonder if the Titan is gonna fit under their tables, and so you can actually just have a look at armrest lowest to highest on the Secretlab technical specifications, and you can basically also remove the armrest if you want. And we're pretty much done.
Okay, we are D-O-N-E. Sizing is a complicated matter, and I apologize if some of your questions were not resolved. But I hope it gave you a little bit of insight into choosing the right chair for you.
Now, a few words on gratitude.
Many of you have come from all across the world to join me on this channel. I really appreciate every single one of you, and I will endeavor to bring you more valuable content in days to come. If you'd like to support the channel, by the way, click like to hit subscribe.
If this video has helped you choose the right chair for yourself, and you've decided you want to help me grow my dream as a content creator in days ahead,
at no extra cost to yourself.
And I expect one from myself.
Go ahead and make your purchase by the affiliate link down below. Thank you for supporting my work in advance.
If you want to help this channel grow,
share this channel with everybody that you know is interested in chairs, ergonomics,
and other content I haven't even thought of yet. Kinda.
It's not the end of the world, damn it.
Yeah. Let's go. Thanks. Bye.
Near, far, wherever you are.
Subscribe.